Atlanta is a vibrant city where sports are a big part of life, from college and professional football to professional basketball, where Angolan forward Bruno Fernando opened his NBA career this season with the Atlanta Hawks. He says the night he was drafted was surreal.
Probably the craziest feeling I've had in my life this far. It's kind of like when you work so hard for something and you know that you've been working for so many years, and it's like kind of like you're putting everything on your back. And just for that moment to really hit and you realize like all this hard work I put in, all this sacrifice I've made really paid off and I'm here now. That was a surreal moment for me. I broke down crying right away. I just got into tears. I couldn't describe. I was feeling all kinds of emotion.
Becoming the first Angolan to play in the NBA does not just happen. The 21-year-old Fernando has worked hard at basketball, moving to the United States at the age of 14, after getting noticed in a game against the US team in an under-16 tournament.
And our last game was against the US, and it happened to be my best game of the tournament as well. So as soon as we went in the tournament and I went home, my parents just like told me that people reached out that I got a chance to come play in the U.S. and go to school here. That was a no-brainer.
Now the Atlanta Hawks rookie is living a dream shared by many other young players. An opportunity, he says, will not go to waste.
I kind of hold myself at a high standard, and it's just another sacrifice that I got to make.
Assistant coach Melvin Hunt says teammates see Fernando as a player eager to learn.
He's like a sponge, and it's all new, and he just soaks up everything that we put out there. So we're having a good time trying to teach him a little bit of everything, and not just basketball, you know, just stuff off the court, on the court, after the game, before the game. It's been a lot of fun.
A game against the Minnesota Timberwolves was his best so far, scoring 13 points in 17 minutes. Fernando shares the credits with his team.
I just give credit to my teammates, honestly. They made a lot of good plays. They found me when I was open. I just sort of run and get open and become available whenever they need me. So I did all these things and they were able to find me, and I was able to score and have my best game so far.
Assistant coach Hunt, who coached superstar LeBron James when he was Fernando's age, says the Angolan player brings a different flavor to a Hawks roster that includes 42-year-old legend Vince Carter.
You play with people that's 22 years in the NBA now, so you get to learn a lot. I'm fortunate that I get to learn a lot from him. And just to be able to ask him questions, pick his brain up, and just learn from his experience and stuff like that, I think makes it a lot easier for me to transition.
Fernando flies on the court, but appears humble and grounded off the hardwood.
It's a lot of people out there that wish they were sitting in this chair right now and be in my position, so you can't ever take that for granted. And be yourself. You don't have to change. And I feel like that is a big thing for a lot of people, for a lot of us rookies coming into the league, because it's something that we never seen. We never had money in our pockets like that. It's things that we never expected.
Also unexpected was an episode during his college career at Maryland that showed his maturity off the court as well. When a rival college announcer referred to him as King Kong, Fernando says he chose to rise above what some social media denounced as racist.
I don't think he meant it in any negative way. You know, I think the way he said it was like of how dominant I was in the game, and just like for the players from the Iowa team not being able to like stop me. It's just that the fact that we got a society that is so into social media, and they just go out there, and as soon as they hear something, they're going to put it out there now. So they just went out there and made a big deal out of it, but I wasn't really worried about anything. I knew he meant it in a positive way.
Living alone in Atlanta, Fernando says he misses his family in Angola.
I was around my family every day, and I don't have that no more, and it's been that way for years now. I don't know when was the last time I was with my mom on her B-day. I spend a lot of birthdays by myself now, but it's part of growth. If you're from Angola, you're going to miss everything about it.
Atlanta Hawks coaches say Fernando's rookie season is off to a great start and shows the Angolan has earned his shot in the NBA. Mayra de la Salette with Betty Ayub, VOA in Atlanta.